Hey folks, in this video I'm going to do the exact same thing to the front porch that I did to the back porch. Remember the railings were out of date? I'll just call them, they've expired just like your old milk. Well, this one's built a little differently. This one's built into a box and it requires 2x8s instead of 2x6s. And as you can see, you remember the video where I put my Christmas lights? I had all my Christmas lights glued right here along this. You can't probably see shit. I'm too far away. I don't know. I can't see nothing. Anyhow, I had all my Christmas lights glued along the bottom of that in sequence. And they were all shaped or aimed the same direction. So what I've done this time is to get them out of my sight to where I can have an indirect lighting. I've went across here with a skill saw and made that to where when I put my railings on, it won't pinch the light or the wire. So I've done that all the way around. I've taken all the wood off that the railing, all the junk wood. Okay, this wood's still good. What I want to do is I want to go ahead and stain this and protect it like I did the other wood, because right now you can see it's just plain wood. There's nothing to protect it if any water gets in there. And you can see how some water has been getting in certain spots. Let me go along here and see maybe some other spots. Yeah, you can see right here water has gotten in there, and a little bit of water has gotten around in here. You can tell from the color, and there's some water over here. Well, I've got the doggone stain out here, and I'm gonna put this on my drill and stir it, get it stirred up real good, and I'm gonna use a paintbrush and just stain it. Stay with me, folks. We're going to fix the front deck. Oh, by the way, what you're looking at here is, that's my umbrella. But what you're looking at here is all the wood that I bought. I needed 4 2x8x8 and 1 2x8x10 for this job to come out just right. Now, you just stick that thing on your drill. That whatchamacallit thing, stick it down into your paint or your stain or whatever, and just give it a go. That'll stir it up. Okay, I'm gonna stir that up. I'm gonna continue stirring that up real good, but I just wanna tell you and warn you to wear old clothes while you do this, and do not remove that from the bucket while the drill is moving, and or else you're gonna get splattered with shit. You know, it's gonna put paint all over you. All right, folks, my stain is all nice and mixed up, so I'm gonna just start putting it on, just like that. Make sure I get everything covered real good before I put my railing planks back on. So I could probably use a roller and do this faster, but I think using this paintbrush will allow me to get a thicker coat of stain on there. So let me go on ahead and go around and stain this wood. And this is also a sealant, not just a stain. So this is going to seal the wood also. And that's what I'm going to do now. And I'll be back with the next step. Well, okay then. I've got one coat of stain on there like I told you I was. And it's even still wet down that end. You can see it's still kind of wet down there. don't touch it. But yeah, I've covered all the tops of that stuff. And what I'm doing here with my boards, I'm waiting for them to dry out, because these are treated. This is treated lumber, and it's wet. When it comes from the store, it is soaking wet with chemicals or whatever they use to treat that stuff. So I need to let it dry out in the sun. So I've got it laid out here, and it's going to dry out for a week or so, maybe two weeks or three. I don't know. It depends on how long it takes to dry it out. Then I'm going to start putting stain on it. Then I'm going to start cutting it and screwing it down to my deck. Stay tuned for that part, folks. Folks, it's time to cut some wood. I'm going to just go ahead and cut it to the size and the miters, the 45s. I'm going to go ahead and cut it and let it sit for a couple days and let it dry out some more even. And then put the paint or the stain on. But I'm going to just run a time lapse real quick of me cutting wood, because if I just showed you the whole video, it'd probably be here for an hour or whatever. So let's time lapse this one. Safety glasses. Okay, folks, I've got my railings cut to the size that they need to be for where they're going to go. And I have a little piece over there also. I might add a piece. I didn't used to have a piece over there, but I had some wood, so I might as well put one there. Anyhow, that's that part. I'm going to lay it back across here and let it continue to dry for a couple days, like I said, and then I'm going to put the stain back on. Or put the stain on the bottom part of it, like I did the back porch. But yeah, this is the front deck. This is how it's gonna look after it's stained. It'll look a lot nicer. Yeah, what's up, folks? How y'all doing today? I hope y'all are doing well. I am doing well. I've got some stain here, as you can see. The wood, I think, is fairly dry enough now to take some stain. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stir my stain up with this little stirring device I put on my drill. Just like that. Get those colors mixed back together. There we go. Looks pretty good to me. Good enough to me, man. It's good enough to me. I think that's nice and mixed up. So anyway, what I'm going to do, I'm going to just roll that on to my wood with a roller. Now, what I'm doing here is the underside of the wood first. This is the underside, which is going to be facing down, just like I did the back porch. If you watched me do the back porch, then I'm doing the same thing with this. So here we go. Time lapse. We'll time lapse this. How about that? That way you don't have to watch this whole, you don't have to watch paint dry. I'll turn on a time lapse for you. As soon as I get going, just let me sit here and bullshit for a minute. Knock some of that off of there. Pour just a little bit of that in there. I always hate this part. It always gets into the crevice of the can, right where it has to seal, and then it never wants to come back open again. So I try to get that out with my roller. Alright, put that to the side. Let's do some painting or some staining. Now I got my boards numbered. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Remember that for when you go to put them back where they go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and work around them like that. So that's how that works. Now, how am I going to paint that one with this one in the way and this one in the way? That's what I need to do. Bring it closer to me. There we go. I need some more. Ta-da! I know you can't see it that well because of all the shading and shadows from the trees, but that's one coat on the bottom. I'll let that dry and I'll come back out here in about an hour and throw another coat on there. I don't claim to be no professional painter or nothing. This is just, you know, just a short little small home project. That's all it is. Folks, here's your quick tip. If you're going to be using your paintbrush or your roller, again, anytime soon, and you don't want it to dry out, just put a bag over it. That's all you got to do. Keep the air off of it. No need to wash this thing off each time if you're just going to be using it again shortly. So I just took a sandwich bag and stuck it around my roller there. And when it comes time to put a second coat on, that won't have dry stain on it. It'll be ready to go. There's a quick tip for you, folks. Okay, folks, I'm beginning to put on coat number two. This will be the last coat for the bottom. This isn't going to be seen anyway. It's going to be underneath everything, so to me it's really not that important to have it perfect. It's just, you know, to protect the wood. It's not to beautify it. Just pay special attention to knots and cracks. Make sure I'm making sure to get a lot on those areas so it soaks down into the crevices. See, like right there's a knot. I enjoy doing these home improvement projects like this. Painting isn't one of my most favorite things to do. It is, you know, I get carpal tunnel. I guess that's what it is. Real easy. Like right now, my muscles are aching in my arm from going back and forth like this, and my hand is hurting from holding this. So every once in a while you'll see that I'll change hands, especially when I can go the other direction. I'll change hands. And there's a knot right there, so I'm gonna pay close attention to that spot. And right there's another one. Now I'm changing hands. I'm going to go back this direction and do this other board, the other end of this other board, to rest this hand a little bit, give it a break. Let me pick up some more paint. Paint on there. just roll it on. Nice smooth silky coat of stain. It's okay if it's not perfect. Once again, I'm no professional and I don't claim to be doing this the correct way. This is not a how to paint video. This is just a video of painting. This is a video how not to paint your camera. Don't paint your camera. I'm going to lift the camera up now. Go ahead and do the end of that board where I had y'all sitting. Right there. That's where y'all were, right there. Okay. That's those three. Now I'm going to get the other three pieces that I've set out of the way. And I'm going to do those. And when I come back in the next part of this video, I will be done with all the staining and I'll go ahead and nail them. So stay tuned for that. I'm fixing to start. By the time you, it's going to take a while for this to dry. But when it's dry, I'm going to start nailing or screwing them down in place where they're going to go. And then I'll paint the other sides. And here it comes. I'm going to do it in this video. Stay there. Here it comes. Watch. Let me just say that this is a 4 or 5 part video, and I'm putting all the clips together, so it's kind of difficult to get it all right in my head what I'm fixing to do and what you're fixing to see. So yeah, I'm new at this. I guess not. Okay, folks, the bottom side is dry. The stain is dry on the bottom, as you can see. So now I'm ready to start screwing this down. I've got me a box of 3-inch screws. This box is $28. $28 for this box of screws. How many do you get? You get 5 pounds of screws. They don't tell you how many there are. Oh, there you do. You get 352 screws for about $28. So anyway, that's me. I'm fixing to start screwing. It's gonna find the spots where they used to be screwed. Then sink them down. Put one there. Let's come out to this side and put one there. Let's flip our board, flip our camera around. Let's put one there. Let's go on out, and I think it'd be safe to say we put one there. There we go. Now I'm just going to continue the process. Probably every 2 feet, I'll put some more. Then I'm gonna go around and I'll show you when I'm done. Okay, folks, I'm pretty much done, except for this last piece of wood. I wanna add one over here. There didn't used to be one here, but I'm gonna put one here. And to do that, there's nothing under here to support it, you see? So what I've got is another piece of 4x4. That I've cut. Now I'm going to screw that there, and then I'm going to put that board on. So that's my last piece. Let me do that, and then I'll be right back. Okay, the last piece goes on. Get it lined up. Dropping my screws everywhere. That's what the magnet's for. That's what I put the magnet on there for. Ta-da, just like clockwork. Let me put a couple more screws there. Probably needs one. Right there. And I want another one right there. Alrighty, sturdy as can be. All right, folks, there we go. So let's take a walk around. And I'm gonna let this sit for a couple days before I stain the top of this. But yeah, here we go, folks. Got a nice deck put back together. Now I'm gonna have a problem right here. I think I'm gonna get a router or something, a sander, and just kind of sand that little, there's a little edge right there. I just want to kind of sand it down. So when you come up, if you put your hand down on it, you don't get poked by a corner. Anyhow, stay tuned for the time for me to stain all of this. Folks, it's time to go ahead and finish the deck. I've got the stain out here. I've got my roller ready. And there ain't but one thing to do. I need to change my shirt because when you go to painting and staining and stuff, you don't want to wear your good shirt. I mean, I've already screwed it up with bleach and everything, but it's still one of my better shirts. I like wearing brown when I wear camouflage and everything. But one of my viewers the other day, I saw him at the gas station with his father, and he told me, he gave me a tip, and he said to always wear your shirt. And it's a good idea for me to always wear my shirt in my video. So I'm going to change my shirt off video and come back with a work shirt on to paint. There. Is that better? I hope so. Anyway, what we got over here is a guy with a shirt on. And we've got some paint or some stain. Let's get to it and let's time lapse this real quick because I'm not going to make you go through this whole thing again. folks, that's coat number one. As you can see on the deck, it's matching the color. Anyway, I'll put another coat on this after this dries, and then the only thing to do will be to come out here at night and plug in the lights and show you how it looks at night. And that'll be the end of this video. Thanks for watching this one, folks. Let's check out the lights at night. All right, folks, this is gonna be the last part of this video. I'm gonna come out here, I'm gonna show you the deck. It's just a little bit light. We got some sky. We still got some sky. There's a sun, there's the moon. It's a toenail moon. Anyhow, we got a little bit of light in the sky, and I'm gonna come plug this, I know you can't see anything because it's that dark. I'm gonna plug this in for you so y'all can see what the lights look like on my deck since I finished it. Check it out, folks. I've got the indirect lighting. It's a lot better than it was before, I think. If you come around here and if you're just gonna walk up onto the deck, like say, here I am, and I'm coming from the street, and I'm gonna come up along the house and I'm gonna say, oh, I'm gonna come visit Kevin. I'm gonna walk up these steps and I'm gonna walk up on his deck and I'm gonna see, this is his deck. This is how it looks. He's got light. Oh, where does that light come from? That's beautiful. That's awesome. Ain't that cool, folks? How the light just comes from underneath the railing along the edges. I hope y'all enjoyed this video, and I hope you enjoy the indirect lighting like I do. I really like that. I hope I never have to change a bulb, because if I do, I'm going all the way up under there, upside down, to try to change a bulb, because that's where they are. Anyhow, thanks for watching, folks, this episode of Home Improvements with a Redneck.